Click. Yes. And I'm recording just myself, so you don't have to be worried about that. All right. Double check one more thing. So start by sitting nice and tall in your chair. Or standing if you prefer, you could stand. Just becoming aware of your posture, a nice arch in your low back, natural arch, shoulders relaxed away from your ears. Lift through the crown of the head. And take a couple deep breaths through your nose. And then let's add the arm movement to the breath. So inhale, reach those arms up and overhead. And exhale, release. And breathe in. And breathe out. Couple more, breathe in. Big stretch up. And breathe out. And one more, breathe in. And breathe out. Great. And then do side to side. So reach down towards the floor. Feel that stretch in the side body. And other side. All right, a few more times, side to side. Great. All right, and then back up. And then we'll lean forward, reach forward with your arms, coming closer to your thighs with your belly, and then power up. So lean back, open those arms, open those fingers. And reach and come up and reach, come up. All right. Really big reach. Feel it in the hips. Great. Few more. Yeah, you don't have to turn around. I was just showing you the angle, the different angle. Good. All right. And now let's climb that ladder. So lift that knee high and lift the opposite arm. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. And then we'll go sideways, so big opening in the hip and back to center. And 2 and back. 3 back. 4 back. 5 and 6 and 7. Feel that stretch in the inner thighs. 8 and 9 and 10. And then let's wake up the core. So we're gonna straighten the legs and cross the arms. So there's a little bit of a lean back. And then you're coming down and arms are back behind you. And then cross, straighten those legs in front of you and dive down. And cross, lean back, and dive down. Lean back, cross those arms, dive down. Lean back. Good. So you need to sort of sit at the edge of the chair so there's some space to lean back. Good. Straighten your legs, and forward. Great, nice work. Let's do some lifting of the toes, lifting of the heels on both feet at the same time. Push for big range of motion. Toes up, heels up. toes up, heels up. Great. Nice. All right. And then let's bring the knees together. And then we'll go side to side just with the knees. So your body, your upper body stays straight forward. And just the legs go side to side. Awesome. And then let's add a little rotation in the upper body. So you're bringing the arms to the opposite direction away from the knees, rotating the upper body as well. Feel that stretch around the upper back, the ribs. Nice. Very good. And back to center. And then we'll work on that standing up. So, the camera. So sitting back down into the chair and then standing up again. Oh, that's too much. Keep going, keep standing up and down. Up, sit back down. Sit back down. Great. Let's do at least five more. One, and sit back down. Two, down, and three, and down, four, and five, and six. Oh, you did more. Okay, let's stand up. But keep your chair somewhere close by just in case you need to reach out. And then while I set up the music, we're gonna, and you can hold on, we're gonna do circles with the ankle on one leg. So weight bearing in one leg and doing a circle with that foot. And then after a little while, switch sides. All right. Okay. Can you hear the music? Yeah? Don't worry, be happy. No? Louder. Yeah, you know, I think this song somehow is... It might get louder with other songs, so let me know if it's too much after. Don't worry. All right. And then let's do that climbing on the ladder. Harder in the standing position. We have some trouble, but when you worry, you make it up. Lift that knee high up. Be happy. Don't worry. Be happy now. All right. Nice. And then sideways, big steps. Don't worry. Turn out that foot. Reach out with that arm. Don't worry, be happy. Ain't got no place to lay your head. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry.
happy. The landlord say you're
lit. And then we'll go across the body, draw a big circle. Wait, side to side.
Be happy. Look at me, I'm happy.
Nice. Right arm. Left arm.
Be happy. Hey, I give you my phone number. When you worry, call me. I make you happy.
Big circle around you.
Don't worry.
Nice. Good. And then let's reach forward and squeeze those elbows back, squeeze the shoulder blades.
Ain't got no cash, ain't got no style, ain't got no
chest up.
Make you smile, but don't worry. Be happy.
And then you can add a little march.
Your face will frown.
Multitasking.
That will bring everybody down, so don't worry. Be happy.
Reach and squeeze those elbows back.
Don't worry. Be happy.
Good. And then marching, regular marching, opposite arm and leg.
Don't worry.
Big arm swing.
Don't worry, be happy. Now there is this song I wrote.
Very good.
I hope you learned it note for note, like good little children. Don't worry.
Nice.
Be happy. Listen to what I say.
Good. And then power rock. So rocking side to side, reaching to the side. Open the palm. Spread the fingers.
Be happy. Be happy now. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy.
Very good. Big reach with the left, right arm, left arm.
Be happy.
Feel your heart rate coming up. Good. Yeah, and then march.
Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't do it. Be happy. Put a smile on your face.
And then we're gonna go.
Don't bring everybody.
Open the right arm back behind you. Even look back.
Don't
and
worry.
Back to center. Reach that left arm back.
Pass, whatever it is.
And forward.
Don't
inhale, worry. Open, rotate. And other side.
I'm not worried.
Few more. Good, nice. Okay, and then we're gonna be reaching side to side. So you're not rocking with the feet now, your feet are glued to the floor, and it's just the upper body reaching. Hold it here. Keep your heels down. Nice. And then let's bring the arms back on your low back. Squeeze the elbows. Walk. Opening those shoulders. Squeezing those elbows. All right, and release, and then push those arms back, push actively, not just momentum, but push against resistance, imaginary, really far back as you can. Work those triceps, and let's tendinous muscles on the back. Nice. And then cross and squeeze those elbows. Cross above your head. Cross above your head all the way. Nice. Great. Oh, here you go, Chris. Now we see you. Now we're gonna go back and push your arms forward. So step back, push forward.
I'm a man without conviction.
I'm a with balance, you could stand behind the chair, hold on, and step back. Back. Yeah. And then we'll stay back on one side. And inhale, arms up. Exhale down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And hold up. Back heel down.
Red, gold, and green.
One thing here.
Come,
breathing.
And
then switch leg.
You come and go.
Other leg back. Front knee bend. And then inhale the arms up. And exhale them down. Inhale. Good. Nice. And then hold with the arms up, chest up. So front knee bend, back leg straight. Stretch those hip flexors. Good. Nice, nice, Andy. All right, let's go. With the right foot, we're gonna go forward, side, and back. And again, forward, side, back, forward, side, back. Still the right foot, forward, side. Forward, side, back, and forward, side, back, good. And then we'll try the other side. Forward, side, and back, left foot. Side, big step, back. Forward. Side. Couple more, forward. Fully shift your weight to that side and to the back leg. And last one, big steps, forward. Side. Great. And then we're gonna go up, side to side. Lift those arms up. And a little pivot. So look up to the right, to the left, to the right. Turn your shoulders to that side a little bit. And look up. Look up. Nice. And then march. And run. Run in one spot. my earrings. Nice. Keep breathing. Great. All right. Take a few breaths. Nice posture. And then we're gonna combine a squat with a side step. So you're gonna go down, and when we squat, we want to see our toes. So your hips have to go back. Stick out your booty. And it brings your weight more into the heels. So it's a little bit of balance issue sometimes. So you have to learn to withstand. So squat and step out. Squat and step out to the other side. Keep your chest up. Keep looking at the screen. Straight forward. Very good. So bend those knees, hip back, and step up. Great. Nice. And then kick your butt. So, hamstring curls. Lift that heel high up. You could hold on if you want. Keep going. Keep moving with some vigor. And then let's add the arm. Still lifting those heels. Good. Nice. And then we'll go tap. Step out and tap, And we'll go with the elbow, big step up, and that knee, elbow. Bend the knees, hinge at the hips, and reach down and stand up. So it's a what we call deadlift. If you had a, some dumbbell or kettlebell. So it's hinging at the hips. So your hips go back, and then you're engaging all these muscles to come up. Imagine you're picking up something off the floor and then lifting up. No rounding in the back. Let the legs work. Good. Nice wider stance so you can have some stability. Good. And then stay here. A little forward position. And then we're gonna reach forward, other side. Engage, nice long spine. Back muscle and core. Very good. Good, and then stretch, straighten up, and we'll add a leg lift. Opposite arm and leg. You could stand behind your chair and keep one hand on the chair. Is the music too loud now, or is it good? No? Okay. Bend that leg back behind you as much as you can. Nice. All right. And then reach up. Up off that high branch. All right. And let's try that game. With the limbs. little. So your right arm will be 1, 2, leg 3, left leg 4. So I'm gonna say 4. Now lift that limb. 3. One, 4, 2, right leg, yeah. Now let's do two at the same time. So I'm gonna say 1 and 3. Same side, yeah. 1 and 4. That's right. 2 and 4. 1 and 4. 3. 1, 2, 3. 4, 1, 2. All right. 2 and 4. Nice. 1 and 4. 4. 3, 4, 1. Good. 4. 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 1. Again, all legs. All right, nice. And then march. Oh yeah, maybe I should give you a water break. Let's have a water break. Do a little hip work. So soften your knees and then stick your hips to the side. Good. And then circle.
Sweet dreams are made of these.
And reverse, go the other direction. Good. And then let's maybe tap the knee or shin if you can, bringing the straight leg forward. Hard on their hamstrings, so do what you can. All right, and let's jump rope. So you're gonna lift the heel, pretend you're jumping. With both arms. Very good. Nice, and shake it out. Yeah, let's do a little kick. And let's add a punch. Good. And then we'll do a side kick. So you're gonna go to the side. So you shift the weight to one leg and you might not go so high if that hurts your hips, but side kick. Feel free to hold on. Good. Nice. Good. And then let's go down into forward fold. Need to bend your knees a little bit. Stay there for a few breaths. Good. And then inhale back up. And then we're gonna try lunging back like this. So if your knee is okay with it, you can lower down with that knee, either holding on or hands on your hips. If your knees are not okay with it, just keep stepping back and you don't have to go down as well. Keep your chest up, more engaged, shoulders back. Good, and then we'll bounce here. Very good, and switch. And bounce or hold. It doesn't work. Very good. Nice. And rotate side to side, pivoting on that foot. Now we're gonna go forward and back narrow, so letter V. Forward, wide, narrow back. Letter B. That's it. Nice. And then we'll go the other direction. So you open the V backwards. So wider back and forward narrow. Back, wide, narrow, or forward. Good. That's somewhat awkward, I know. Good. And then let's just lift the leg without doing this, right? So upper body straight up, just working the hips. Hold on, maybe stand behind your chair. Lift that leg straight out to the side, toes point forward. Awesome. Very good. All right, let's inhale, reach up and overhead, and exhale, forward fold. And then inhale, reach up, exhale, forward fold. One more, inhale up, and exhale. All right, nice. All right, let's do maybe another 5 minutes of a little cardio. So opposite knee and hand. That's it, nice tall posture. Great. Nice. Good. And then just a little bounce in the knees and big arm swing. Send one arm back, one arm forward. Great it. And feel the little rotation that happens when you do that, right? So we're not fighting it. Your shoulders rotate side to side a little bit. And let's stay here for a few breaths. Switch, look to the left. The left and right. So my chest is facing to the left if possible. And then to the right. Nice. Very good. And then step forward with the right foot and we're gonna do kayaking. So you have a paddle, or I guess it's called a paddle, right? And then dip it on one side and then the other. Rotation at your track going on. Good, and then switch legs, same thing. Other foot forward. Ooh, look at you, Chris. You have a almost a paddle. Great work. All right. Okay, let's slow down a little. So let's take a downward facing dog stretch. Let's turn on the music. So we'll use the chair, either the back of the chair or your seat. And then step away from the chair until your back is nice and long, arms long. And stay there for a few breaths. Imagine someone's pulling your hips away from the chair. Feel the muscles stretching around the spine and stretching the armpits, the undersides of the arm. Great. And then we'll hold plank for some strength building. So bring your hips forward towards the chair until possibly your shoulders are above your wrists and your butt is in line with the rest of the body. So core engage, brace your core, lift through the back of the heart. You know, if this is too hard, you could lift your butt a little higher, and as you get more, as you get stronger, you will be able to support this whole body in a straight line. So chest is lifted. You're not collapsing through the chest. Good. And then release. All right. We'll do one more thing here. I guess you could do it on the floor too. So I'll show you first this version. We're just gonna stretch the hips by taking a really big step forward with hands on the chair and then holding on. You could do it on all fours. It's a little harder on all fours and then step that foot forward. And then other side. So just try for a big step. So you feel that stretch. Possibly you could also do it this way with the chair, but kneeling down and then stepping forward and bringing the hips closer. And do maybe five on each side. Stretch at the hips. Good. Nice job. Okay. All right, and then we're gonna do a few cobras. So we'll be on our belly. If you don't wanna be on the belly, maybe your back is too sensitive. You could do it on the wall. So you're gonna, I hope you see me, put your hands on the wall, shoulder height, standing a few feet away from the wall, and then you're gonna let the chest come to the wall first. So it's, you're coming up with the chest first, opening this whole area, right? Pushing into the wall. If you're doing it on the floor, gonna look like this. So hands by your chest, press the tops of the feet down, going down, and then left without pushing into your hands. So use just the upper back and then exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. You could possibly also do it in the chair. That would look like this. So inhale, shoulders away from your ears, chest up, There's a little arch in the back, right? And then exhale. And inhale, just keep your shoulders away from your ears. And open your collarbones, broaden your collarbones. So if you're doing it on the floor, you wanna also look like this, right? Not like this, but like that. So really open here. All right, let's see. Yeah, just use, Stuart, can you come all the way down on the belly? Or is that too much? Yeah. Now I don't see you much, but that's fine. Just try lifting your chest a little bit off the floor. So you feel that engagement in the upper back. Good, nice, nice. Wade and all good, that's it. I don't see some of you, but it is hard work for sure. Because there tends to be a lot of stiffness in the upper back, but if you want good posture, the cobra is a good way to strengthen the upper back muscles that keep your shoulders back and keep you nice and upright. All right, and then if you've done a few cobras, you can roll around onto your back, and then we'll bring the knees into our chest. If you're seated in the chair, just bring one knee into your chest at a time. But this feels pretty good on the floor, so I always encourage everyone to try to maintain that ability to come up and down off the floor. Even just because when you fall, you know, you need to get up, right? So practicing that is a good skill. And then from there, we're just gonna straighten one leg towards the ceiling at a time. If you're in the chair, just straighten one leg straight in front of you. Bending and straightening that knee. Flex the foot as if you wanted to put a footprint up on the ceiling. Good, and then see if you can do both legs at the same time. Straighten both and bend both. Straighten and bend. Core engaged. Good. And then one more thing here with both legs up. And we're gonna scissor them. So open them wide and then scissor them, cross them. Open and cross, open and cross. We'll work in the adductors and abductors, inner thigh and outer thigh muscles. Great. And then lower the feet down. And we'll do a few bridges. So bridge pose, lifting the hips up. So bend your knees, feet flat, knees are parallel, arms by your sides. And then press into your feet, squeeze the glutes and lift up on the inhale. And exhale down. Breathe in. And breathe out. Lift up and down. Few more. Feel that stretch in the front of the body and the engagement in the back of the body. And then if you can hold up in the upper position for a few breaths. Breath flowing. And slowly release. Nice work. And then bring your arms up and overhead. So maybe you can floor with your thumbs. If not, don't worry, but try to really reach all the way towards the floor. Hold the arms there. Hold that stretch. And then bring the arms into cactus. So bend at the elbows. So you're gonna be in this shape, kind of like a robot. I call it cactus. 90 degrees at the elbows. But your elbows and possibly the hands touch the floor. Sometimes it's not possible anymore, but do your best. And then you're gonna also bring your knees and feet together and then open the knees to the side. So you're in butterfly pose. So it looks like this. Feet down, knees open. And then on the exhale, you're gonna bring the knees and elbows together. Inhale, open the elbows and knees to the side. Your feet are down, so your feet are supported by the floor and you're just moving the knees apart and together with the elbows. Right, a few more. Nice work. And then release. If you crave another movement, you can do it now. Maybe knees into your chest again or windshield wipers, moving the knees side to side. Or maybe just a big stretch, whatever works. And then settle in Shavasana. So relaxation pose, either lying down or maybe legs up on a chair or sofa or wall. Just somewhere where you can relax and where you feel comfortable and warm enough. And bring your attention into your toes. The soles of your feet. Your ankles. Your shins. Calves. Knees. Thighs. And your pelvis. Your buttocks. Your belly. Your low back. Your chest. Your shoulders, arms. Hands. And fingers. And your neck. Upper back. Your jaw, cheeks, eyes and your eye sockets, and now become aware of your whole body. And take three nice long mindful breaths through your nose, deep into your body. Letting the belly rise on the inhale. Awesome, and then start moving your toes and fingers. Maybe take a stretch. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side. And come up to sitting. Great work, everyone. Great. So for the new people here, I close the class with this little sort of loving kindness prayer. You can join me, but you don't have to. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead as a reminder of the power of your thoughts. Your lips as a reminder of the power of your words. And hands to your heart. As a reminder, the power of your actions. Thank you, everyone. And maybe think something you're grateful for today. I actually almost got into an accident just before the class started. So I'm grateful. I had a client in the morning in Piedmont and I was going home and this lady suddenly comes into the opposite direction. So I was going this way and she comes into the opposite our direction, and then she, like last minute before I bumped into her, she crossed in front of me and drove into the like lawn or bushes or whatever. It was so crazy. So I was like, oh my god, that was close. That was scary.
Be careful, Petra.
It was not my fault. She went into the wrong direction. I don't even know how she showed up there, you know. It was like out of the blue, and she was going pretty fast too, and I could see that she was like shocked or whatever, so she was like swerving right in front of me and went, yeah, it was scary. All right, so grateful to be here.
Yeah.
We're grateful too, Petra.
All right, I'll see you guys next week, okay? And I'll send a video so you can do it again on another day. Keep moving.
Thank you.
All right, bye.